If you want to know someone's heart, observe that person's final journey. With his mission still before him, Jesus stopped his disciples and told them for the third time of his conclusive encounter with the enemy. "We are going to Jerusalem. The Son of Man will be turned over to the leading priests and the teachers of the law, and they will say that he must die. They will give the Son of Man to the non-Jewish people to laugh at him, and beat him with whips, and crucify him. But on the third day, he will be raised to life again. Forget any suggestion that Jesus was trapped. Erase any theory that Jesus made a miscalculation. Ignore any speculation that the cross was a last-ditch attempt to salvage a dying mission. For if these words tell us anything, they tell us that Jesus died on purpose. No surprise, no hesitation, no faltering. Jesus stepped toward Jerusalem with the promise of God in his heart. The divinity of Christ assured the humanity of Christ, and Jesus spoke loud enough for the pits of hell to vibrate. But on the third day, he will be raised to life again. You can tell a lot about a person by the way he dies. And the way Jesus marched to his death leaves no doubt. He had come to earth for this moment.
To die on Calvary.
God is on a cross. The creator of the universe is being executed. Spit and blood are caked to his cheeks, and his lips are raked and swollen. Thorns rip his scalp. His lungs scream with pain. Taut nerves threaten to snap as pain twangs her morbid melody. Yet death is not ready, and there is no one to save him, for he is sacrificing himself. Far worse than the breaking of his body is the shredding of his heart. His own countrymen clamored for his death. His own disciple planted the kiss of betrayal. His own friends ran for cover. And now his own father is beginning to turn his back on him, leaving him alone.
Zion shall Israel sing, here he is, behold your king, Lamb of God sacrificed upon a tree. Zion shall Israel sing, God becomes an offering, your Messiah.
There was some dice throwing that went on at the foot of the cross. Imagine this scene. The soldiers are huddled in a circle, their eyes turned downward. The criminal above them is forgotten. They gamble for some used clothes, The tunic, the cloak, the sandals are all up for grabs. Each soldier lays his luck on the hard earth, hoping to expand his wardrobe at the expense of a cross-killed carpenter. Here are common soldiers witnessing the world's most uncommon event, and they don't even know it. As far as they're concerned, it's just another Friday morning, and he is just another criminal. Come on, hurry up. It's my turn. All right. This throws for the sandals. Casting lots for the possessions of Christ. Heads ducked, eyes downward. Cross forgotten.
Close to
The Jews could celebrate. Jesus was out of the way. The soldiers could celebrate. Their work was done. But Mary Magdalene couldn't celebrate. To her, the last few days had brought nothing but tragedy. Mary had been there. She had heard the leaders clamor for Jesus' blood. She had witnessed the Roman whip rip the skin off his back. She had winced as the thorns sliced his brow and wept at the weight of the cross. So in the early morning mist, she arises from her mat, takes her spices and aloes and leaves her house, past the gate of Jenneth and up to the hillside. She anticipates a somber task.
It seems like only yesterday I walked this way with him. We spoke of hopes and promises.
Are dimmed with tears, and it seems like some great tragedy has filled your heart with fears. Woman, woman, your eyes with sorrow. Not gone at all, for the one you seek is me.
Tom,
The frightened disciples gathered once again in an upper room, daring to dream that the Master had left them some word, some plan, some direction. Then they heard a voice. Peace be with you. Every head lifted, every eye turned. They saw Jesus. They encountered the Christ. Their sins collided with their Savior, and their Savior won. Think about the first time you ever saw him. Think about your first encounter with the Christ. Robe yourself in that moment. Resurrect the relief. Recall the purity. Summon forth the passion. Can you remember? Do yourself a favor and stand before him again. Or better, allow him to stand before you. Go into your upper room and wait. Wait until he comes, and when he appears, don't leave. Run your fingers over his feet. Place your hand in the pierced side and look into those eyes. Those same eyes that melted the gates of hell and sent the demons scurrying and Satan running. Look at them as they look at you. You'll never be the same.
Made us his people to reign.